So in my last theming video, I got a lot of comments asking me to make a video on making Scratch 3 look like Scratch 1.4. And here it is. So let's get started. First of all, you need a Google Chrome extension called Scratch Add-ons. So before we get into the installation part, let me tell you that this extension is completely safe to install. It does not take any personal information at all. So feel free to use it. So to get Scratch Add-ons, go to scratchaddons.com and click on install. And this will redirect you to the Chrome Web Store page. Here, click on add and wait for it to get installed. Then in the top right corner, click on this 3D box icon or maybe the puzzle icon. That totally depends on your browser. Click on it and select Scratch Add-ons. Now go to the add-ons section and then search for customizable colors and turn on edit a dark mode and customizable colors. Then click on the down arrow right here and scroll all the way down to presets. And here choose the Scratch 1.x preset. This add-on will basically change the colors of the editor to look more like Scratch 1.4. Then search for customizable block colors and turn it on. Again, click on this down arrow and scroll down all the way to presets. Here, you can choose Scratch 2 preset as the block colors of Scratch 2 and 1.4 are basically the same. This add-on does what it says, and that is change the color of the blocks to look more like Scratch 1.4. After you have done this, search for customizable block shape and turn it on. This time, we won't use a preset, just input the values I have put. This add-on basically changes the shape of the blocks to look more like Scratch 1.4. This is some next level customization. After you have done that, search for reverse order of project controls and turn it on. This add-on will basically move the green flag and the stop button to the left side of the stage and the screen size controls to the right, just like Scratch 1.4 had. After doing that, search for two column category menu and turn it on. This add-on will basically make the Scratch category menu look like this, which is exactly what Scratch 1.4 had, and even Scratch 2. After doing this, search for mouse position and turn it on. This add-on basically shows the X and Y coordinates of the mouse pointer in the Scratch editor, just like Scratch 1.4 did. I know this is pretty insignificant, but still, the more accurate, the better. And finally, search for customizable default project and turn it on. Now to put the project ID, first make a new project and in the cat sprite, go to costumes and convert both the costumes to bitmap. Now save the project and copy the project ID, which is the number right here, and then paste it here. From now on, whenever you create a new project, it will have the bitmap scratch card instead of vector, just like Scratch 1.4 had. And yeah, that's it. This really looks like Scratch 1.4. You can just see the comparison right here. Watch this video next to know how to make Scratch 3 look like Scratch 2. Thank you for watching.